She's right, that's the action part. So now we're going to do the dialogue part. Usually, you know, they do it together. This is experimental theater. I was just joking earlier, Jeremy. You could do a show called Watch Me Work Out. And you could be like in the gym. You could do, what do you do? Push-ups? Like chin-ups?
Yes.
You could do that, and then we could like cut to Jeremy. You know, right? That's how this got started. That's how this show got started. So, I was making a joke. Here I am. So now we're going to do the question part. So who, anybody, has a... Oh,
yeah, a good one. From Cape Town, South Africa.
Oh, you're Cape, really?
Yep.
Or somebody who says they're in Cape Town, South Africa. Sorry.
Live streaming right now, writing all the way in Cape Town at 11:15 p.m. Internet magic.
Watch me work late. Hi, Cape Town, South Africa.
Amy.
Hey, Amy. All right.
And her question is, I can never get started. How do you overcome the hurdle and the pressure of the first words that opening sentence pay you?
Wow, what a great question, Amy. How do you overcome the word, the terror? Did you say no? Did I say that?
Hurdle and pressure.
The hurdle and pressure, which I think of as terror. So, which is to say, Amy, that I would say, maybe a quick show of hands, that I'm not the only one who has this fear or feels this hurdle. Does anyone else have a prayer? Like, how do I get started? Right. So there are other people, Amy, and that's a good thing. Because, first part of the answer is know that you're not alone in your fear or in your, when you see those hurdles and feel those pressures. I won't say it's fear. For me, it's fear. And the best way to do it is by doing this writing exercise. It's really complicated, and it's, I know people are laughing, it's the only exercise I ever give, which is you sit down and you get a timer, something like this, and you sit down and you put the time in. And you actually just start, if you type on a computer or a typewriter, or you write longhand, you just put the time in and start writing. And believe it or not, that actually gets you over those hurdles. Imagine, you said hurdles, right? Imagine, so you know, hurdles, like real hurdles, like anybody watch the Olympics, like last year? Right, they do that with their legs. Imagine if they were, they would run up to the hurdles and just stand there. You have to take a step, and they take very specific steps. They kind of look like that. So we have to take a step, and as writers or as artists, our steps are just what we're doing right now, right? Put the time in, right? So I would say put the time in and check back with us and try that. Pick your favorite part of the day, which might be now for you, way over in South Africa, and set a timer for, say, 30 minutes and start writing. And it will work miracles, I promise. Money back guarantee. Anybody else? Thank you so much, Amy. But please keep up with us, because we adore you. We're happy. Oh, remind me of your name.
Lee.
You've been here before, right?
Yeah.
You're doing a one-woman show?
No.
Yes, I am working on that actually right now, because that's a finished thing for me.
Congratulations.
And I have another project that I've been working on soon, and I'm prepared with this question today because it's sort of been the working part. Last week I just wrote down about six times keep showing up while you were talking.
Very good. Like,
and that's good. And so it's more about I'm in a place now where I'm having trouble when it's time to talk about it, like the thing, and say, you should come, or you should want to know more about this, or like how to do the next thing. Like the effort of sort of thinking, you guys talked to me a little bit about producing a little bit, and sort of the like, as I stare at this press release thing, and at that point you have to start to like say what this thing is.
Right. Very good.
Is there a question there?
Yeah, Lee, your name's Lee. I just want to get that right. So Lee has a question. Did everybody hear her? That she's doing a show right now, so she's accomplished some stuff, right? She's done a show or two, she's written some stuff. Been here and other places writing and performing, right? And now she has this question where you're right, you've written this other project, you've already written it.
Well, it's sort of still a little bit of progress because it's a collaboration, but at this point I've got to talk about it because it's a lot.
Right, so you've got to talk about it, you want want to attract producers or audience members, yeah, at least, okay? And how do you talk about something? And it's almost like you have in you more than one, there's more than one lead, right? And you have to, if there's the writer lead, let's just pretend she's like, writer lead, right? There's performer lead who's on stage, right? And then there's press release writer lead, who's a different person. Who can like work a room, right? Glad hand people, smile and talk about her work. We all have this in us. And if we don't, and if we have a part of us that's like weak, like, oh, I don't like talking about my work, that's, you know, Jeremy will tell you, you go to the gym and you work on that tricep, that muscle, right? Because that's something that you need to be able to do if you're an artist. You need to be able to talk about your work. So you gotta kind of exercise that part of yourself, right? I would just say the same thing. You put the time in. You know, and or try it out with your friends. Try it out your performer. Try it live. Try, you know, pitch it to your friends. This is what my show's about. This is why it's awesome. Do it live, and then you'll start hearing things, and then you can write them down. Try it live, maybe if it's not, if you're freezing at the typewriter or at the computer, try it live. Set yourself a deadline, same rules apply. When do you have to have it done?
I think it should be done by the
end of this week. Like, as in Friday,
Friday
or as in Saturday?
Friday.
Friday, like at 5?
Sure.
Plenty time. I love it. Okay, Friday at 5, you're gonna be done. So, what's the day? Wednesday? At like 5:45, 6 o'clock? Great. Okay, so you have those, that time allotted, right? So you have some friends that you can call up even, and go, I'm gonna pitch you this, I'm gonna try it out, a couple different friends, they can give you feedback. You can type up something on email, they can give you feedback on it. Okay, so that's your deadline. Just keep showing up and just do it. Do you have a title? You sure have a title? Great. Sing the praises of the collaborators, you and the other people. Just say blah, 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 whatever, and then your friends will help you hone it down and sharpen it. And you've got a title, that's like half the battle. Just tell people what it's about. No? And don't worry, like, oh, people don't like it. Don't start thinking with your, like, negativity brain. Just think, you know, you're working a room. Hey.
I think, and I think the struggle, too, not to monopolize the time, but is this, is to be not, is to be, I don't know, I think what I'm having trouble is that I see what I'm writing, or I hear what I'm saying about it, and it sounds, doesn't sound like what the thing is, you know what I mean? It sounds a lot more serious or maudlin in this way. I'm like, yeah, those are some themes, but it's fun.
Well,
like,
you put that in, look at your body, oh, look at that. You're talking about it like this, get up and start talking about it. Like you're talking to your producer, you're in their office, and you're like, hey, I got this great show, you gotta see it. It's this, and then go like that. If it's not working out by sitting down and, you know, your energy is puddling and you're, you know, you gotta stand up and write. Cool. Anybody else? Yes, Lynn?
Yes.
Oh, I rehearse at home.
Yay. Susan?
Suzan-Lori.
Suzan-Lori?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you.
Okay.
Or you can call me SL.
SL?
Actually, or SLP if you want to, you know, go for it.
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
I've always had this question. I think great writers, wonderful writers, read an awful lot.
Right.
And I've been, you know, I grew up dyslexic, and I read really slow, so I feel, I mean, this is a negative thing.
Right.
I feel like I haven't read enough to be a good enough writer.
Okay.
Could you address that? I saw this wonderful piece of theater called Sontag Reborn.
Oh, yeah. And New York Theater Workshop?
New York Theater Workshop. And it's so exhilarating.
Right.
And I recommend it to everybody, but... the thing I also was left with was that there she is, reading,
right.
Things that I didn't even imagine to know.
Right.
So that's my question.
Right. So Lynn says writers, in her experience, and I think we'd agree, writers read a lot, you know? But my answer to you is if you're dyslexic or you grew up dyslexic, and reading is difficult for you, why make
No, I
that?
Do read.
You do read, but why, no. But so you don't feel like you've read enough. So I would suggest that perhaps the truth that you're believing writers read a lot, maybe it's not true. Writers write a lot. we do. We write a lot. Right. We write a lot. Writers put the time in and get the writing done. Right? I mean, there's a truth to writers read a lot, but why, if reading has been historically tricky for you, why make that a roadblock? Like, all writers are tall, or writers are, or all people who are happy, you know, wear high heels, or, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you could believe that watching Sex in the City. They're all happy, and they're all walking around. They're all beautiful women in New York City wear high heels. Jimmy Choo, high heels. Expensive Choo. You could believe that. But instead, we're like, hey, maybe happy people wear Birkenstocks or whatever, you know, sneakers or whatever. Right. You see what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So just leave that alone. Suzan Sontag read a lot. She's awesome. Yeah, but she read like more than me, and am I gonna like look at her and go, oh shit, I can't write because I haven't read as much as Suzan Sontag? You know? She also had like a white, gorgeous lock of white hair. Do we need to dye our hair like that?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah. go on then. You go that way, and I'm gonna go some other way over here. You see what I mean? So, but we do that a lot. We set up these self-limiting beliefs in our mind that make total sense. But they don't have to. If it's getting in the way of you doing what you want to do, then maybe it's just not true. In all cases. You know, there's a whole tradition of, think of like Homer. You know.
Yeah.
Did he read a lot?
Well, there weren't a lot of books around.
So like he didn't read a lot. He was also blind, right? I mean, maybe he had someone read to him, but he probably heard a lot of stories.
Yeah.
But he didn't read a lot. And there are plenty of storytellers throughout history who are illiterate. There are plenty of musicians who can say, oh, I want to be a musician, but I don't read music. Great musicians throughout time have not been musical.
Revision, and I find that revision is more difficult than writing for me. But the experience of other people here as well.
Right.
So I'm just trying to think if there are any suggestions about approaching revision or ways to think about revision as just like writing plus or something.
Huh. What's your name?
I'm Gabrielle.
Gabrielle, oh, you were here last week. Yes. Gabrielle, so Gabrielle, you heard her. There's some people in the hall, in the lobby. She's revising, and for Gabrielle, revising is more difficult than writing?
Yes, often it's more difficult because it feels more difficult. It doesn't feel as alive, it doesn't feel as fresh, it doesn't feel, you know, when I first start saying, what a great idea, and then you look at it again, maybe this is an echo of something that you said, and so it's harder to stay the course with it.
Oh, right, because there's that sort of voice of,
it becomes a more critical one,
right. Do most people have more trouble with writing or rewriting? People have trouble writing first draft? No? Yes? A few people? Rewriting? So it's kind of like more people have trouble reading. Wow, I'm in the first camp. Because in the second camp, you know, the road has been laid, and I'm just walking around like picking. Oh no, I think I'll plant that flower over here. You know what I'm saying? So what I do is get into the character. You know what I mean? So while you do have a critical. This is an exercise. No, we've done this exercise. We haven't done this before. Well, this is fun. So, rewriting, what's your favorite piece of music right now? Fun way to look at it. Just off the top of your head, just not. You can change it.
It's not easy being green.
It's not easy being green. Great. Is that, and okay, so what? So if you had a choice between the colors black, brown, white, or gray, which would you choose?
Black, brown, white, or gray?
Yeah.
Gray.
Okay. And great. Okay, that's all we need to know, I think. So, is not easy being green, the color gray. So you're on a gray, beautiful gray horse. In your, which hand are, do you write with? Which is your right?
Yeah.
Okay, so in your hand, your right hand is the sword of discrimination, not racial discrimination, but the ability to tell the shit from what's not the shit, right? And you are riding this horse. And It's Not Easy Being Green is playing. And you are cutting everything that does not belong. It's a fun, joyous, it was a fun, joyous thing. You're in the flow. A lot of times we think rewriting, you get out of the flow and get critical and start thinking, right? No, no, no. You're in the flow. You're flowing. The flow is the story or the play or the novel or the poem. You've already laid the path for it. And you're just riding and just cutting. You don't have to worry about cutting too much, you can always put back in, but you know what I mean? And you just cut, and it's a joyous process because you're in the flow. Okay? So when I say get into the character, just get into the joy of it. Ride the story. You've already made the wave. Just enjoy it. Okay, so yeah, so don't, you know, you're not going, oh, bad girl, you wrote the wrong word there. You're not doing that. You're going, oh, yeah, my character, oh, it's not easy being green. How does it go? Yeah, I know, but how does it go? polish it, right? And you're gonna let go of the expectation of the audience and what they want, what they their takeaway, and well, I know what that means, you know? And you're gonna let go, it's gonna feel good to you, and then you're gonna, it's gonna be good enough, and you're gonna go on to the next one. And that doesn't mean that it's not, you're not allowed to wanna be brilliant, because you probably will be brilliant. If you, I set the bar very low, I tell people, really low, the bar is very low. And somehow when you set the bar very low, you can become very expansive and wonderful. There's an opportunity to come to life. I know, it's like magic. It's like a Zen card. Go figure, Gabrielle, go figure. Okay, you should try that. And they write lots. You can write a lot. Anybody else? Everybody cool? Or cool enough? Thank you guys. Thank you guys for coming. Thank you.
No, it should be.